I want to visit with you on the topic of encountering strangers for this Palm Sunday morning. This is the beginning of Holy Week. There's a chilling opening scene in the movie Promising Young Woman. The main character, played by Carey Mulligan, is playing a trick on a man who picked her up in a bar thinking she was drunk. While they're back in the man's apartment, he's trying to make a move on her, and he says to her, "I feel such a connection to you." Suddenly, she snaps out of her act and begins questioning the man's connection. "If we're so connected," she asks, "what do I do for a living? How old am I? How long have I lived in the city? What are my hobbies? What's my name?" He can't answer any questions, even with his so-called connection. He saw her as a one-dimensional creature who could serve him in a one-dimensional way. In recent conversations with strangers, I've met people who seem to view me one-dimensionally. After I ask and they answered questions about their lives, they ask nothing of me. They weren't curious about where I'm from. What do I do for a living? How old am I? What are my hobbies? What's my name? And certainly not my religion. I experience a total lack of connection and curiosity. Could it be the pandemic has caused people to become so inwardly focused they don't notice people around them as multidimensional? Well, it's not the pandemic. It's the human condition. The exact thing happened to Dez, Joe's barber in the movie Soul. Dez wanted to be a veterinarian, but life threw him a few curves, and he chose manicuring human hair over manicuring mutts. Joe had no idea Dez was so deep. Why? Joe was so focused on the music, jazz, he never asked Joe about his life. Dez and I have something in common. Well, the Bible tells us Jesus was curious about the strangers he encountered from all walks of life. He saw them as human beings with very complex lives. The parables portray a man who saw people's souls. He was skilled speaking to strangers, family, politicians, religious leaders, and common people. He was born for this pandemic. Citizens of the biblical world were no strangers to pandemics. During Jesus' time, leprosy was the pandemic of the day. Known today as Hansen's disease, leprosy caused sores on the body and affected the nervous system. Lepers were treated worse than people with COVID. They sent them to lepers' colonies. The Hawaiian island Molokai was a lepers' colony. Jesus injected people with a vaccine called faith. The shot he administers was a cocktail of belief, courage, and affirmation. One of his first miracles was healing a person with leprosy. He healed 10 more lepers. He was curious and courageous when confronting the leprosy virus. There was no lockdown, you know, and he created his own version of herd immunity. Dealing with strangers requires courage. The more you encounter strangers and talk to them, the easier it becomes. I've encountered strangers who helped me in ways I couldn't have predicted. Strangers help you find your way when you're lost. They teach you new things. They have information on how to live your best life. Strangers give solutions to difficult problems. Often, strangers have things in common that lead you to become best friends. I became a Unitarian Universalist because of strangers I met along the way who were UUs. The first UU I met was during my first year of seminary at Southern Methodist University. I didn't meet another UU until years later as a PhD candidate at Texas Christian University. The UU who brought me along was a woman I met during hospice chaplaincy. She encountered me as a stranger when I called her, but she treated me as a distinguished guest in her home, and our conversation changed my life. I remember her as an angel, turning strangers into angels. As a traveler, I enjoy striking up conversations with strangers. I've discovered the best things, restaurants, pubs and breweries, fishing holes, and places to shop by asking strangers. It boils down to getting vulnerable with another human being. Jesus was the model of vulnerability. In the Palm Sunday story, he rides into town on a donkey, the sign of humility. People laid down palm branches to honor this King of Kings going to trial. And as he rode into town, people shouted, "Hosanna in the highest!" Even as a king, he was a stranger to most. Well, how might Unitarian Universalism change if we found new ways to welcome strangers? I am a member of the UUA Nominating Committee, which creates the slate for all UUA-level committees for General Assembly. We put together the Presidential Search Committee, nominate the UUA Financial Advisor, and most of the UUA Board of Trustees candidates. This year, we're expecting a group of UUs known as the Gadflies to contest one of our Board of Trustees nominees. Why? The Gadflies are against multiculturalism and UU efforts to disrupt white supremacy. For the Gadflies, Unitarian Universalism has fallen short of its promise, and multiculturalism is strange and disrupts UU traditions. UU siding with love must rise and say no to the Gadflies at GA, then outvote them and send the message that they're falling short of UU promises and that their attitudes are unwelcome. Many UUs view the Gadflies as the opposite of humility. They represent what UUism is not. And Jesus' strange ministry said no to many ancient traditions, which included making women and the poor less than, keeping a caste system, and putting religious practices ahead of people. For example, people stoned women for adultery. After his famous pronouncement, "Let them without sin cast the first stone," people stopped casting stones. That long-standing tradition needed to go. Speaking of leaving, I heard about this pastor and song leader who weren't getting along, and it started to spill over into the services. One Sunday, the pastor talked about the importance of being a giver. Afterwards, the song leader got up and led the song, "Jesus Paid It All." The next week, the pastor talked about not gossiping and watching your tongue. The song leader got up and sang, "I love to tell the story." Another week, he talked about being willing to change. The song leader got up and led, "I shall not be moved." The pastor was so frustrated, he resigned. He told the congregation, "Jesus brought me here, and Jesus is taking me away." The song leader then led, "What a friend we have in Jesus." Well, this stranger, COVID-19, has cast out many long-standing traditions. Who would have thought we'd start working from home? What a positive change that has been. That may become a new normal, and I'm expecting the UU Church staff will continue this norm once New Mexico is fully open. We will change many long-standing traditions because of the pandemic. Henri Frederick Amiel said, quote, "Conquering any difficulty always gives one a secret joy, for it means pushing back a boundary line and adding to one's liberty." Well, the Palm Sunday message is about pushing the lines which held people in bondage. Class bondage, legal bondage, physical bondage, financial bondage, and of course, spiritual bondage. The marketing guru Seth Godin, who I've watched on a recent Compassion Seminar says that people use perfection as a way of hiding their true selves. Until things become just right, they don't reveal their work. The solution, he says, is to show up even with the bad stuff, and eventually the good stuff will come through. Sometimes on Zoom meetings, I wonder, who is hiding their true selves? What might we see if people shared their screens? What if we all shared our screens? Not your PC screens, that would be chaotic, but the screens to your soul. Where is it written that we should hide our soul, our true selves, from one another? I can see it clearly, the Church of the Imperfect Souls. And I imagine such a congregation might be filled to capacity every Sunday. The people might include strangers that are people we say are strange now. Trumpers, Republicans, gun owners, people with tattoos, anti-vaxxers, and for many, Black Lives Matter supporters, or even the Eighth Principle supporters. It's hard to understand for many how these people came to their views, but I suggest they are easier to understand if we take time to be curious about them. Suppose we become more curious about Jesus, the human being. What if we were more curious and less angry, more interested and less judgmental about the complexity of his personhood? We might change our beliefs. As Sam Harris, the well-known atheist, said, a belief is a lever that, once pulled, moves almost everything else in a person's life. Palm Sunday was less about right belief and more about right action. And I believe it's time to lay down palm branches for one another in order to endure this pandemic and adapt to the new normal. Let's not emerge more stranger, but stronger. The Palm Sunday model of how to help us gives us more connection with strangers. No tricks needed. We can use this model to remind ourselves none of us is a one-dimensional creature. We're all multifaceted people who change the world every day, like it or not. And remember this, what a friend we have in Jesus. Be well, my friends, and enjoy the coming Holy Week. I invite you all to join us here on Friday at 6 p.m. for our Tenebrae service. And of course, we hope to see you here next Sunday for Easter Sunday morning. Amen, Ashe, and may it be so.